So this video is on how to actually complete an online ballot. This is assuming you've watched the previous video or you already have a Tabroom account. As I had mentioned in the registration process of Tabroom, it gives you an opportunity to put your phone number and an email address in. I want to show you the benefit to that. As I had mentioned that if you put a phone number in, it will send you a text message with your judging assignment. I can't show you the screen of my phone, but I can show you the text message that I got as it comes through my computer as well. But here is the example. I received a text message. It's got my name, judging round one, in room 207, and the team codes 153 versus 157, and it's reminding me that we need to flip for sides, and that I will have a flight to at 4:30 p.m. And then above, you see it sent another text message with the same information, and for flight one. So if you're in public forum and it is double flighted, you'll get a flight one and a flight two. This will work for all debate events, including LD and policy. This will work the same way for speech. I'm going to show you the speech ballot online process here after debate first, because there's a few things about speech that I want you to be aware of. But this is just like if it were to come on my phone via text message. Then you don't need to wrestle over any going to get any postings on paper or asking your coach. It comes straight to you. The other nice thing is in Tabroom, sometimes we make judging changes. It will also let you know via text if something changes, and there will be a message associated with it. So just for the simplicity of it, I put the message, go. Go ahead and head to your round. I can put in as tournament director whatever message I'd like to help remind you, or send some message out about a change specifically that affects you. So it's a great way for judges to stay in connection with the Tabroom. Now, if you don't have text messaging or you prefer not to do it that way, but you also get email on your phone, you can see that it also sent me an email. Here it says the same information, and so we are connected again. So via email or text message is a great way to get your postings. When you're ready to go to your round and judge, you'll just log into Tabroom using that same account that I walked you through before. So I'm going to use my judging account as an example. Put your username and password in. And here's what makes it very easy. The very first thing you see is a screen that shows you that same pairing to judge, the one that you got in your email and text message. So on the left-hand side, it shows that I'm judging public forum round one, flight two. I'll be in room 207. It starts at 4:30 p.m. And it's got the teams 54 and 58 that I'll be judging. Now, this is an important detail, is this green button right here, start round. We don't want to push that green button until we're actually in the room and the round is ready to start. What this does is it tells the Tabroom that it has started and we are ready to go. So on my end, as running a tournament, it would say at, let's say you started at 4:30. At 4:30, this round started and we know it's good to go. If there's ever a time where I don't see a round start, I'll know we're missing a judge or there's an issue with that room, and we can target that from a Tabroom perspective. Now you will see on the right hand side some judging options. You can see any upcoming ballots, and so in this case I've only been assigned to one, but you can see that I've been put in the judge category LD or public forum. So if you're curious about what category or what judging pool your coach put you in, that is a great place to find out. And then conflicts. You can actually add some conflicts in. So if there's a school you just rather not judge, or you have a personal conflict, like you don't want to judge, maybe you have a relative from another school and you just don't feel comfortable judging them because you know them well, you can put their information or their Tabroom account and it will make sure that we do not pair you with those individuals. The other option is your history. So I've never done I just created a new count for the purpose of showing everybody, but normally you would see all the different tournaments you judged at, and you could click at them and view the comments and decisions that you made. Also, if you have a judging paradigm, a perspective of how you would like the debaters to know how you judge, you can provide that information in here, and it will be available to the debaters coming into the round. So this saves time on asking, If you've judged before, they'll ask you if you have a paradigm, and you can post that paradigm right there. So with that said, we're going to pretend like we're in the round and we have our teams in front of us. We'll just click start round because now we know we've got the right people and we are ready to go. I would encourage you to also have flow paper and any scratch paper so you can take notes on the round just in case your battery dies or something goes wrong. You always have kind of that paper perspective that you can go back and refer to. So we would click start round, and what it will do is it will provide us the ballot, the same ballot essentially that you would get on paper. On the right hand side, you will see that it is round one, that we are in the right room, and flight two. On the left hand side, because we flip in public forum, it gives us the chance to change it. So we'll pretend team 153 and 157 flipped, and let's pretend 153 flipped for the negative. So we just use that drop down menu to change it. And then we would change them to affirmative. So we can see, we will see then the names of the team. And in this case, these are just test teams, but you would normally see a set of names. And then on the right-hand side of the column, we are able to put speaker points in on a range from 20 to 30. So the debate would conclude, we would go in and we would put speaker points in, just like so. And then we would choose our winning entry. We this drop down menu, and we're going to pretend like 153 wins, and they are on the negative. So we would choose the negative. This is not a low point win, but there is that option if you'd like. Now, before we click submit ballot, we're going to scroll down and you'll see some general feedback. We always want to leave a reason for decision, also known as an RFD. And in this box, we can give our feedback and our critique of the round. And this is an important process because debaters see this. Now, everything under the Reason for Decision tab is seen by both debaters. So both teams see it. You'll see that, however, there are two tabs, tab for team 153 and tab for 157. If I click on one of those, it gives you that warning. These comments only go to the team 153 and their coaches. Now, some people would appreciate and would advocate that you put all comments so both teams can see, so especially at a tournament like state, so we can be really transparent with the comments that we're making. But if you so choose to make something very specific, it can be viewable to that team, those coaches, as well as the tab room. So we'll put a reason for decision. We'll just say the neg did a better job, and of course we are going to want to put in a robust, well-articulated reason for decision, but for the purposes of just demonstrating today, we'll put something simple. Something else I'd like to make you aware of is you can always come back and edit these comments later. So if you're stressed and you're like, oh, I have a lot to say, but I want to help the tournament move on, you can fill this part out, put something simple in here, and then go back later on that evening and fill out more effective comments if you'd like. So at the end, we're going to save comments in the ballot, and then it's going to bring up a verification screen, and it's going to say that you chose, or we chose, 153 on the neg, and these are the speaker points that we gave. So the negative on the left, the affirmative on the right, those look correct. We can, oh no, that doesn't look right, we can re-enter it, or we can confirm our ballot. And once that ballot is confirmed, it says results in RFD, a summary of what we just did, team 153 won on the neg. With the RFD, the neg did a better job. Now it will also show up in our history. If I click on there, we can see that I made that decision. And we can go back in and edit those various comments if we wanted to. And so once that is done, the tab room already knows and can see that decision instantly. So it's very, very effective and very helpful to us. So with that said, that is how you submit a ballot for debate. I'm going to go ahead and stop this video, and I will create a third video on how to do a ballot for speech and some of the different nuances associated with that.